So, if you've wondered how long it would take to watch each phase of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, well, boy, do I have some stats for you. So in phase one, you had 6 films totaling 12.4 hours. In phase two, you had another 6 films, but this time it was a fraction longer, clocking in at 12.7 hours. Phase 3 turned it up a notch with 11 films and 24.9 hours. And then so we have Phase 4, which up until this point has consisted of 6 films and 7 shows. That is including Thor Love and Thunder and all of Ms. Marvel. 49.5 hours. Even from the point of view of an MCU fan, a diehard MCU fan, that's ridiculous.
Okay, so first off, I just want to say, I get it.
You get what?
High school.
Kamala.
Kamala.
Another adventure shirt. Cute.
She thinks I'm some kind of weirdo.
You were a weirdo.
Boys. Excuse me.
Yeah.
You're kind of on my shirt.
Sorry.
But you're staring out the window in your little fantasy land. Kamala. Hey. Already? Really? Come on. Like.
Do I have to figure out my whole future before lunch or is there like...
How's it going, guys? Welcome back to my channel and time for another episode of Luke's TV Reviews. Today, well, I said it in my Thor Love and Thunder review that we're doing this a lot more regularly now. The MCU, guess what? There's more. And this time around, we've got a brand new hero entering the universe, but will she make a big enough impact to avoid getting lost in the crowd in Ms. Marvel? And as usual, spoiler warning, that is right, spoilers for the whole show, including the finale, you've been warned. Kamala Khan is like many of us on Earth, a gigantic fan of the Avengers, with her absolute favourite being Carol Danvers, aka Captain Marvel. But her strict parents don't appreciate her reveling in such frivolities. But when Kamala comes across ancient bangles that used to belong to her grandmother, she quickly discovers the power they contain, and begins to make a name for herself as a wannabe superhero. I've actually been hoping for a while now that Kamala would get her live-action debut within the MCU, but I was a little dubious going in because, based on the comics, her powers have been sometimes a little silly, and I'm not sure how that would translate to live-action, especially because they have recently, in Doctor Strange Multiverse of Madness, introduced quite a famous stretchy superhero. So, despite what some very loud fans on social media may say, I really dig how they've interpreted Kamala Khan for the MCU. I really like the changes that they made to do with her powers, how they look, and what that means going forward in the MCU. I will touch on that later, however. But I think most importantly of all, this show just wouldn't work unless you had a charismatic lead actor driving this thing forward, and the good folks over at Marvel Studios just really are insanely good at casting, because their pick of Iman Vellani is sheer genius. Vellani has seemingly come from nowhere and is now almost instantly synonymous with the character of Ms. Marvel. Her charisma is effortless and she fits into the MCU mold brilliantly whilst also allowing her own potential to shine through. I honestly think in years to come we'll look back on her performance as one of the best castings in terms of superhero castings that we've seen. Joining the ranks of Hugh Jackman, Ryan Reynolds, and Robert Downey Jr. She is that good. Plus, it's also pretty helpful that Vellani is a self-admitted MCU fan as well, which goes to show that if you dream big enough and you have those ambitions, and you also have an acting coach and agent, then you too can be in the MCU, just probably as an extra. But for me, the series was at its best in the opening couple of episodes, where it's really focused on Kamala's relationship with her parents and discovering her newfound powers. And I think that's mostly because of how down-to-earth everything felt, and it boasted some really refreshing direction, with directors such as Adil El Arbi, Bilal Fallah, and Mira Maron showing off some really creative flair, filling the episode with vibrant visuals and loads of energy. You see, following on from the chaos within the multiverse and gallivanting with gods, it was a really refreshing change of pace to spend time in New Jersey about a teenage girl who is not having a fantastic relationship with her parents and also just happens to discover that she had now her superpowers. And Kamala's parents, I would argue, are the heart of this, or at least the first few episodes. Yeah, I know that there's this whole overprotective angle, but I adored how they did their best to accommodate Kamala's interests whilst also still wanting to remain in their predetermined comfort zone. Take the scene with her father dressing as the Hulk to take her to AvengerCon. I mean, it's heartbreaking to watch Kamala reject their offer, even though you know that it's for her own good. So if I'm being honest, I was just kind of hoping that that was what the rest of the series would be about. Kamala coming to terms with her newfound powers and embracing the opportunity to become a superhero, but you have her parents doing everything they can to keep her grounded. And then, yeah, sure, in the background you can have damage control as the antagonists wanting to take Kamala in. But unfortunately, the story shifts into more of a generic superhero tale as they introduce a group of villains who just so happened to be directly related to Kamala's ancestry and wanting her powers for their own nefarious gains. It was a neat touch to have Kamala go back to partition-era Pakistan and save her grandmother, but that overall arc seemed to last close to like 3 episodes, and I'm still not sure the point it served. Because to detach almost immediately away from this community that we'd spent 2 episodes investing in and getting to know, Kamala's friends and her family, as well as the Muslim community within New Jersey, and then to just almost leave it behind and go on some completely other adventure, it basically felt like you had 2 stories going on at once here. Because all the stuff with the djinn, it was good, but you could save that for a second season. I think the first season, it would have been so much better for the sole focus to be on Kamala, her friends, her family, this community. The only other significant negative that I have in the show are the visual effects. Kamala's powers do look fake. I don't think there's any major intention for them to look real in the first place, but it does pull you out when your TV is just covered in cosmic-looking crystals. But by the time we reached the finale, it stuck the landing. Of course, it devolved into your typical MCU punch-up with copious amounts of VFX, but to see the growth in Kamala as a character, finally embracing her powers and responsibility as a hero, it made some of the slower parts of the show eventually worth it. And so in terms of where do we go from here? I was very happy to see that we got plenty of tidbits and teasers sprinkled in. First off, mutants are now a thing within the MCU. Given the focus on Bruno's findings of Kamala's genetic makeup, plus the very obvious riff from the animated X-Men show, this marks the first appearance or acknowledgement of mutants within the MCU, or at least Earth 616. And if I'm hedging my bets, I don't think that this is going to be the last we hear of mutants, especially when Kevin Feige steps out on stage in Hall H in a couple of weeks' time. Just a hunch. And also, that mid-credits thing. Finally, we get a post-credit scene or a mid-credit scene that actually feels like they're setting up something interesting, rather than throwing an entirely new character at us, or just a throwaway gag. We were all waiting to see if Brie Larson would actually make an appearance, and she does, just not in the way we expected. So it looks as if her and Kamala have swapped either places or bodies, and that's all I need to know. And it's made me more excited for Nia DaCosta's The Marvels next year. On the whole, Miss Marvel had its ups and downs, but almost all the downs were redeemed by the beacon of charm that is Iman Vellani. It was almost impossible not to be having fun whenever she was on screen, and I think Marvel have been on kind of a roll in Phase 4, especially when it comes to introducing new heroes like Shang-Chi, Yelena, Kate Bishop, Moon Knight, and now Miss Marvel. I do wish episodes 3, 4, and 5 shared the same creativity that 1, 2, and the finale had, as well as a more streamlined approach to telling its story. But the show has clawed back some of my confidence in the MCU. I think recently they've been coasting along, but there are plenty of flashes of what we know the MCU are capable of throughout this show. So I'm going to give Miss Marvel a 7.5 out of 10. Anyway, guys, those were my thoughts on Miss Marvel. Let me know, have you had the chance to see the show yet? What did you think? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. And my question to you, I briefly mentioned it in my review, but what do you think Marvel Studios and Kevin Feige are going to be announcing in Hall H in a couple of weeks' time at San Diego Comic-Con? Here are some of my guesses, predictions. I think we're going to get our full Fantastic Four lineup. I don't think that the X-Men or an X-Men movie will officially be confirmed, but I think there will be confirmation that they are going to be working on it very soon. I think we'll learn a bit more or a bit more information about the Blade movie starring Mahershala Ali. And I also think that this big, I want to say endgame, but not like the film endgame, but this big project that we're inevitably going to be building to, I think they're going to reveal it as Secret Wars. Or none of that will be mentioned, and us typical MCU fans will just overthink everything and then be inevitably disappointed when things don't meet our expectations. It is fun being a fan. But anyway, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Hello! Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have, make sure to click that like button, and if you aren't already, click that subscribe button too.